Feature matching. Welcome friends in the session of feature matching. Feature matching technique is used in computer vision to map or to find out a correlation of features identified at the period of training of the algorithm, and those features are tried to match with the features which are available or extracted in the test image. So once you have created your features during the training phase of the algorithm, then these features you are matching with the new image, and once the features are matched, you are finding that a given object is classified correctly or it is recognized correctly. In feature matching algorithm, many algorithms, many performance parameters are taken into account to find out to what extent the accuracy is obtained during the feature matching stage. So in this session, we'll see what is a feature matching, what are the performance parameters which are used to match the features, and gives you the information that what is the accuracy of feature matching. So we'll start the session with this concept of feature matching. There are some important stages during feature detection and matching. The first step is feature detection stage. This is a stage where each image is searched for locations that are likely to match well in other images. See, for example, we have one image and we are interested in a specific object in a given image. And there are many objects of different categories which are present in the image. So in feature detection process, when our object of interest is identified, we try to find out that similar region in the next new image at any particular location. And this stage is called as feature detection stage, where the features which are identified, those are used to find out similar objects in the image or the new image. Next step is feature descriptor stage, where each region around detected key point location is converted into a more compact and stable or invariant descriptor that can be matched against other descriptors. Consider, for example, we have one image where we wanted to detect, say for example, a human. Then we have some features which can detect the head, which can detect some other part of the body. Then when we want to describe our feature so that our object can be easily detected, then we try to make our features more compact. So some part of the head feature, some part of the shoulder feature, you know, some part of the torso features, they are joined together to form one different feature. So this compact representation of multiple sets of features, they are used together in order to find a similar object of interest in the new test image. Next step is feature matching stage, which efficiently searches for likely matching candidates in other images. So here, any feature, let it can be a line, then this can be matched in the new image where the line is present, whether it is of different orientation or whether it is of different scale. And finally, the fourth step is feature tracking stage. So this is an alternative to the third stage that only searches a small neighborhood around each detected feature and is therefore more suitable for video processing. So feature tracking would be prominently used in the video processing, but whenever you need not to find out or need not to track the images, then first three stages are very important. Whenever there is a need that object needs to be tracked, some features needs to be tracked, then only feature tracking stage is used. So out of four stages, the first three are very important. The fourth stage is optional, or it is used for video processing. And these four steps you have to consider while development of your computer vision algorithm for finding, extracting, matching and tracking of the features. So let's discuss more about feature matching. So once you extract the features and their descriptors, as we mentioned earlier, from two or more images, the next step is to establish some feature matches between these images. So what is important is that first you have to select a matching strategy. For example, your matching strategy can be just a correlation, or say it's a template matching, so that one region of one image can be matched in the second image and you are finding the similarity index between the two. So you have to devise one matching strategy. And second step is you have to devise efficient data structure and algorithm to perform this matching. Say for example, whenever one wants to search any particular object, one can use, for example, a tree data structure for feature matching criteria. There are many data structures available like trees, track, queue, and one has to very efficiently elect a specific data structure as per need of the project. The matching strategy and error rates. A more general process which involves transforming feature vectors into a new scaled basis is called as the whitening. So what you can do whenever you wanted to scale down your features, so that you wanted to keep your features in a specific confinement, then that scaling is applied to the features. This process is called as the whitening. Given a Euclidean distance metric, the simplest matching strategy is to set a threshold, or say a maximum distance, and to return all the matches from other images within this threshold. So while matching finding, one benchmark has to be set by the developer, and you have to return all the matches within that benchmark so that you are sure that how many features are being matched. Remember, setting the threshold too high will result in too many false positives. False positives are nothing but incorrect matches being returned. It's a new term that we'll discuss in the next slide. And setting the threshold too low, it will result in too many false negatives. False negatives are nothing but too many correct matches which are being missed. Let us consider this diagram and you will understand the concept of false positives and negatives very clearly. Say we have a circle and we have a black one written, and we have another circle and we have a black two. Right? Now here black digits 1 and 2. The black digits 1 and 2, they are the features which are being matched. Right, then the green one is a true positive because it is falling within the threshold of this one. So the threshold is shown by this black line, black solid line. Right, so the green one is close to this one and it is falling within this boundary, and so it is called as true positive, or it's a good match that we have seen, we observed. While the blue one, as shown over here, it's a false negative, it's a failure to match. What happens that algorithm says it's a negative, that the feature is not correct, but the decision is false because it is just close to one, and as we have restricted our threshold to this extent, this one which was the correct match, it is outside of the threshold. And therefore, it is considered as a false negative. Algorithm says that it is not a feature that you are looking for, but that is false. That is a concept. The red 3, on the other hand, is a false positive. Your algorithm says that this red 3 is within this threshold which has been identified, but unfortunately, even though it falls within the threshold, it is not your correct object or correct features which you are looking for. So the red 3, even though it is within the boundary, it is considered as a false positive. Your algorithm says it is a match that has been observed, but it is not correct. It is false. It's false match. So this concept is called as false positive. Right? If we set the threshold higher, which are shown over here by the dashed lines, then the blue one becomes a true positive. So this is how, by increasing the threshold, you can change your false negatives into true positives. But when you do so, when you increase the threshold to the dotted circle, then your brown 4, it becomes an additional false positive, because it is not the object of interest, but because you wanted to accommodate this blue one, you are increasing this threshold and you are taking a additional feature into account which is not correct. So in all, setting the value of the threshold is a very cumbersome and challenging practice, and setting of the threshold too low or too high may lead your detections towards a good side or towards a bad side. So very intuitively, you have to decide the feature so that your true positive rate and false negative rate, as well as your false positive rate, they are up to the mark. Friends, we can quantify the performance of a matching algorithm at a particular threshold by first counting the number of true and false matches and match failures using the following definitions. So the first definition is true positives, short form is TP. These are nothing but your number of correct matches, the matches which are correctly happened, and they are the true objects, they are the true features. So they are considered as, they are true positives. Algorithm says it's a positive test, and that is true sense. Second performance parameter is false negative. This indicates the matches that were not correctly detected. So your algorithm fails to detect those matches. The next performance parameter is false positives. These are proposed matches which are incorrect. Algorithm says these are your probable results, but they are not correct. They are false positives. And finally, the fourth performance parameters for quantification of matching algorithm is true negative. It indicates non-matches that were correctly rejected. So algorithm says your results are negative, and which is very true. So true negatives is the non-matches that were correctly rejected. So on this background, friends, we have four definitions with us. The first definition is true positive rate, and that is equal to number of true positives divided by number of true positives plus false negatives, which we call as P. So the formula is TP upon P. The second definition is false positive rate, FPR, which is number of false positives divided by number of false positives and true negatives. This false positives and true negatives, the denominator we consider as N, so our formula is FP upon N. The third definition is positive predicted value, or PPV. This is equal to true positives divided by number of true positives and false positives. And finally, the accuracy of the algorithm is given by number of true positives plus number of true negatives divided by number of P's and number of N. When number of P's are true positives plus false positives, and number of N
are number of false positives and true negatives in all. So these four definitions are very much important to quantify the performance of your algorithm, and these performance parameters indicate how your algorithm is powerful. So here is a task for you. So it's a homework for you all that you can now work out. I'll give you a few minutes, you can just try to solve it. So for a given matching strategy, following parameters are estimated. The number of true positives are 85, number of false negatives there are 7, number of false positives there are 15, and number of true positive negatives are 15. You have to tell me the answers for four parameters. Number one is what are the number of true positive rate. Second, you tell me what is false positive rate. Third, you tell me what is positive predicted value. And fourth, what is accuracy. I'll give you 2 minutes time and you can just work on this numerical. So friends, here are the answers. Please verify these answers with your answers. So the true positive rate is around 92%. Number of false positive rate is 23%. Positive predicted value is almost 85%, and the accuracy is 85.98%. So I am sure that your answers are pretty much tallying with these answers. Let's discuss receiver operating characteristic, which is called as ROC curve, and its related rates. So let's plot a graph. On x-axis we have false positive rate, whose value is ranging from 0 to 1. On y-axis we have a true positive rate, whose value is ranging from 0 to 1. And now we have the graph which is shown by this blue line. So ideally the true positive rate should be close to 1, while the false positive rate should be close to 0. So the answer, ideal answer for false positive is lying to 0, while ideal answer for true positive is lying to 1. So that way my ideal curve is my y-axis. There should not be any false positives, while the true positive rate should be at 1 or 100%. The area under ROC curve is often used as a scalar measure of algorithm performance and is called as equal error rate. So my equal error rate I am measuring. So this is the area under this curve. This definition of equal error rate is used many a times to indicate the performance of the algorithm. So when you find out the number of true positives and when you find out the number of true negatives, you have the boundaries false positives and false negatives. They are with close distance from the TP curve and the PN curve. So there is the term called precision, which is often used, and the precision indicates that how many return values they are relevant. Your algorithm shows these are the correctly features which are identified. Say it finds out 10 features, but out of 10 features how much are relevant. So that indicates your precision, and that is used sometimes instead of your positive predicted value, or called as PPV. On the other side you have a recall rate, which indicates that what fraction of relevant values was found. So say out of 10 values, 8 you find they are very much relevant. But what is the fraction of relevant values are found? So you may have the 9 values which are relevant, and out of 9, if you are finding 8 values, which are relevant, then your recall rate is 8 upon 9. So friends, closer this curve lies to upper left corner, that is the larger the area under the curve AUC, the better is the performance. This is a very important point that you can note it down. The ROC curve can also be used to calculate the mean average precision, which is the average precision PPV. Thank you.